Hey, hello. Good morning. Welcome to our Friday edition of Morning Inspiration. And for today, our morning Bible inspiration will come from the book of Romans, chapter 8, verse 1 up to 8. Ulitin ko po ulit. Romans, chapter 8. Verse 1 hanggang 8 po, basahin po natin. Therefore, there is now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. Because through Christ Jesus, the law of the Spirit of life set me free from the law of sin and death. For what the law was powerless to do, in that it was weakened by the sinful nature. God did by sending His own Son in the likeness of a simple man to be a sin offering. And so He condemned sin in a simple man in order that the righteous requirement of the law might be fully met in us, who do not live according to the sinful nature but according to the Spirit. For those who live according to the sinful nature have their mind set on what the natures desire. But those who live in accordance with the Spirit have their mind set on what the Spirit desire. The mind of sinful man is death, but the mind controlled by the Spirit is life and peace. The sinful mind is hostile to God, is that it does not submit to God's law, nor it can do so. Those who control by the sinful nature cannot please God. Yan po ang ating morning Bible inspiration for today, Friday. And this is another day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. And again, welcome po sa ating morning inspiration. Today is Friday weekend na naman po. And I hope that we are being blessed by the whole week of sharing with you inspiration taken from the Word of God. And another day today, just as we open said in our opening remarks, that this is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. So we are hopeful and we are thankful. We are expectant of God's mercies, of God's never-enduring graciousness, and we have the trust, faith, and confidence that He will going to meet us in our daily activities. That the Lord may somehow meet us on a certain Damascus of our areas in order to meet us personally and take part in everything that we are set to do. There are many challenges, there are many trials, and a lot of opportunities that this day would bring to us. All that we need is to have that kind of faith, that whatever that would come today with God on our side, we could always be a winner for this day. Yesterday po, we were talking about repentance. Ang pag sinabi po natin repentance ay paghingi ng patawad, no, at sa ating mga kasalanan, And yun po, the open call for repentance is always there. It's always present. We don't have to stay in guilt of everything that somehow, even as Christian, we still do some sins in our life. Or even if we are already Christian, there are some certain darkened areas of ourselves, of our life, wherein sin is trying to hide. But all of this darkened areas of our life as Christian will be exposed by the by the power and by the ministry of the Holy Spirit to be able for us to comply yung pong dapat sinless po tayo, yung sinful nature natin, it is not already in a way being with us still, but we are already following the spiritual nature of our being, a new creation when we receive the Lord as Savior and Lord in our lives. The power and the ministry of the Holy Spirit will be working together with us to be able to explore or to enlighten us more of what are those darkened areas of our lives wherein we haven't yet submitted to God. And that is the work of the Holy Spirit. So when we receive the Lord Jesus as our personal Savior and Lord, the sinful nature was taken away from us. And we are now living our spiritual side of our life. We are living under the Spirit, the guidance of the Holy Spirit. And when we reach that point, it is expected of us to live not under the sinful nature anymore of ourselves, but in the spiritual nature of our new self, because we are now a new creation. We're talking about repentance yesterday, and today we will be talking about no condemnation. Minsan po, medyo pag pinag-uusapan po, intriguing itong subject matter na ito, yung no condemnation. Actually po, this is the reality of being a Christian po. Remember, before the Lord, God the Father, had decided to send His Son to die for all our sin, we are already condemned because we are living under the sinful nature of our humanity po. Because of the sin originated from Adam and Eve, we have inherited that sin in us, no po, and that is why, because of that nature that we are, the sinful nature that we inherited from Adam and Eve, no po, we are already condemned, no po, we are condemned, no po, and that is why the Lord had this plan to be able to take away the condemnation of our sinful nature and be brought into His fold once again. So He planned to send His only begotten Son, which is our Lord Jesus Christ, to be a sin offering, to condemn sin once and for all. That is the reason why, no po, Jesus died on the cross to save us, to receive the condemnation of our sinful nature and offer His life to wash away to the blood of Jesus that flows in the cross of Calvary, to once and for all take away the condemnation of our sinful nature. Yung pong sin, kailangan pong i-condemn ng Diyos. Na po. And that is why He was brought here on earth to die and to receive the punishment, the condemnation of all the sinful nature of all mankind. Yan po yung purpose, no po. Kinamatayan na po ni Kristo yung pagkukondena sa ating sinful nature. He received all the punishment during the crucifixion, and He was able to win that when He rose again after 3 days. So, who will going to condemn us? Well, in fact, Jesus Christ died and the sin was been condemned already when Jesus Christ died on the cross. So there's no more condemnation in us because it was been condemned already during the crucifixion of the Lord Jesus Christ. The dying on the cross is a punishment for the sinful nature of all of us. And when Jesus rose up again, that is the moment that establishes our being new creation. And exactly when we receive that the grace of eternal salvation, we are not anymore under the sinful nature of mankind, but we are now a new creation. All the sins was been condemned, was been paid by the Lord Jesus Christ on the cross, and that is a gift. No, so there will be no more condemnation. There will be no more guilt supposed to be, because Jesus already had carry it out in the cross of Calvary. So when we talk about condemnation, how about on the second coming? According to the Bible, we will be judged on the second coming. Since if we have truly been received the Lord Jesus Christ as our personal Savior and Lord, that is wholeheartedly, we became a new creation, and during the second coming, on the judgment day, we will pass the qualification to enter the kingdom of God, because we have accepted the Lord Jesus Christ to be our Lord and Savior, and that eliminates the sin in us, because Jesus washes that away. But we should have the real kind of relationship with the Lord. So upon the second coming, when the judgment time come, we will enter into the glory of heaven with our Lord. So, pag pinag-uusapan po natin yung repentance, tapos parang in some people, in some Christian, pag pinag-usapan po yung repentance, pag pinag-usapan yung sin, ay parang nagiging judgmental ang tingin. But actually, it is always an open call, because we're still living in this world, and that the fact is nasa paligid natin ang kilos at deception ng kalaban. And sometimes we really have that time that even if we don't want, we still commit some sins. But that does not eliminate the fact that these sins that we have committed was already condemned during the death of Christ in the cross of Calvary. That is included already. Because we are now living under the Spirit of God in us. We are not under living the sinful nature of ourselves when we receive the Lord Jesus Christ as our personal Savior and Lord. And the gift of no more condemnation is there already. Hindi na po mai-eliminate yun if we have that true acceptance of what Jesus had done on the cross for the salvation of sin. Remember, yung pong dying on the cross, ang main focal point ito, tayo po. Pero ang pinaka-other main focal point ito is yung sin of mankind. Yung po yung inales at yung po yung sinave ng Panginoon. He received all the punishment. He received all the condemnation of all our sin. Yun po yung essence ng pagkamatay ni Kristo. And who will do that again for us? Receiving the condemnation of sin. Receiving the sinful nature of us. that was been brought about and settled by the Lord Jesus Christ upon giving His life on the cross of Calvary. No more second offering, wala na po. Kaya po, the totalness of all our sinful nature, past, future, and present, was been cleared out, served by the Lord, no, Jesus Christ. So, now we are not living under the sinful nature because we are a new creation. We are now living under the Spirit of God. So we have that power to battle with the sinful nature. Hindi po isang salita lamang yung pagtanggap natin at yung ginawa ni Kristo when we acknowledge that Jesus died on a cross for all our sins. Hindi po basta ganun lamang po yun. It carries out our entire human being, and it carries our present, our future, and until the second coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. The dying on the cross has an eternal value for all of us, mankind. The eternal value is that the Lord wants us to be together with Him in heaven after this life. And if we have received the Lord, the grace of God, the grace of salvation, no po, and eternal life, no po, yan po yung essence noong ng lahat ng ginawa ni Kristo, yung madala tayo sa kaharian ng Diyos sa langit, no po. So yung pong binasa natin sa Romans chapter 8 verse 1 to 8, life through the Spirit. Sabi po, basahin lang po natin ulit. Therefore, there is now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. So sinasabi po, no more condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. So since Jesus have received the punishment, Jesus has received already the condemnation of the sin, no po, during the hardship and the dying on the cross. Na-receive niya na po yun. Yun po yung focal point na ginawa sa atin ng Diyos, no po. Kaya no more condemnation of all our sins, because all our sins was included, the past, the present, the future, doon sa pagkamatay ni Kristo, kasama na po yung kabuuan ng lahat ng ating mga kasalanan. No po. At ang dugo ni Kristo ay patuloy na dumadali ngayon, and if we have acknowledged and received that gift of salvation and eternal life, nando na po yun sa package na yun, kinuha na po at pinaghirapan na po at kinamatayan na ni Kristo yun lahat ng ating mga kasalanan. So when the time comes on the second coming, we will be facing the Lord Jesus Christ. He will not be talking about our sins if we really have received the Lord as our personal Savior and Lord. Because through Christ Jesus, the law of the Spirit of life set me free from the law of the sin and death. For what the law was powerless to do, in that it was weakened by the sinful nature, God did by sending His own Son in the likeness of sinful man to be a sin offering. And so He condemned sin in sinful man, in order that the righteous requirements of the law might be fully met in us, who do not live according to the sinful nature, but according to the Spirit. So yun po, sinabi dito. And so He condemned sin in sinful man, sa atin po, no po, yung sin, na condemn na po. Every sin, ibig sabihin, hindi lang yung sin from the sinful nature na inherit natin kay Adam and Eve until the second coming, everything is composed, is already included on the dying of the cross. Kaya no one can now separate us from the love of God if we have received the Lord as our personal Savior and Lord. Those who live according to the sinful nature have their mind set on what that nature desires. But those who live in accordance with the Spirit have their mind set on what the Spirit desires. So that is now expected of us. If we really receive, and acknowledge, no, that the Lord Jesus have died on a cross, no po, there will, yung ating mong mind setting will not answer to the sinful nature's desire. But if we have truly received the Lord as our personal Savior and Lord, we will live now in accordance with the Spirit and have set our minds to what the Spirit desires. So, nagkaiba na po. Dati, we are living under the sinful nature and that our minds were set in accordance to the nature of our sinful nature desire. But now that we have received the Lord as our personal Savior and Lord, the Spirit of the Lord is working in us. It's working on our mind. And we are now, our minds is now set on the desire of the Spirit that we have received when we acknowledge and receive the Lord as our personal Savior and Lord. So meron na pong battle na nangyayari, no po. And to be able to stand on that spiritual desire on our minds because we have Jesus in our heart and mind, no po. Now we have, there is a battle now between the sinful nature desire and the spiritual nature desire in our being, no po. And that is where the power of the Holy Spirit will help us and do His ministry for us to be able to stand on the desire of the Spirit that is within us now and reject what the sinful nature wants us to do, no po, and to keep on sinning, no po. So yun po yung pangyayari, yun po yung ibig sabihin na to. The mind of a simple man is death, but the mind controlled by the Spirit is life and peace. So yun po. The simple mind is hostile to God. It does not submit to God's law, nor it can do so. Those controlled by the simple nature cannot please God. Tuloy ko lang po ito sa 9 ng Romans chapter 8. You, however, are controlled not by the sinful nature, but by the Spirit. If the Spirit of God lives in you, and if anyone does not have the Spirit of Christ, he does not belong to Christ. But if Christ is in you, your body is dead because of sin, yet your spirit is alive because of righteousness. And if the Spirit of Him who raised Jesus from the dead is living in you, He who raised Christ from the dead will also give life to your mortal bodies through His Spirit who lives in you. So, therefore, brothers, we have an obligation, but it is not to the sinful nature to live according to it. For if you live according to the sinful nature, you will die. But if by the Spirit you put to death the misdeeds of the body, you will live. Because those who are led by the Spirit of God are sons of God. For you did not receive a spirit that makes you a slave again to fear, but you received the Spirit of sonship, and by Him we cry, Abba, Father. The Spirit Himself testifies with our spirit that we are God's children. Now, if we are children, then we are heir of God's and co-heir with Christ. If indeed we share His suffering in order that we may also share His glory. So, yun po yun. No po. So, if we receive the Lord as our personal Savior and Lord, the Spirit of God is within us. And the ministry, the work of the Spirit will continue working in us, no po, totally rejecting the spirit of the sinful nature that was taken away by the Lord Jesus Christ on the cross, no po. So now the battles begin, no po. Talaga pong dumadaan ito sa isang proseso, but we have the power of the Lord that could be our assurance that we could now fight the battle of our sinful desire, sinful man desire, and the desire of now the Holy Spirit that is within us. Kaya pong sabi po, if the Lord had win over the battle of sin, no po, and yung pong purpose ng dying on the cross was served, He won over the sin, no po. He died because after 3 days He rose again, no po. He didn't keep dying, no po, because of the punishment of the sin, but He rose again, yun po. So tayo po sa ating mga kasalanan, meron tayong kapangyarihan na we do not anymore being condemned by these sins, but we became alive at the same way that Jesus been alive after 3 days during the time of the resurrection. That is a sign of being victorious over sin, over death. The death of sin happened and He came alive. And our death to sin happened during the death of Christ, and we came alive again when Jesus resurrected after 3 days. So the payment and the condemnation of sin was being paid already on the death of the cross, and become victorious after 3 days. So we have that power. We should acknowledge and we should reflect it and be totally submissive to that sacrifices on the cross of Calvary, na ginawa ng ating Panginoon. But when we accepted that, we are already out of being on a sinful nature. That is why the Lord had died on the cross. We are now under living a new life. When Jesus resurrected, we have received a new life at the same time. And now we are a new creation. The old things have passed away. Behold, new things have come until the second coming of the Lord. No one can separate us now from the love of God because of the dying of the cross. No sin is not being paid already, was not being paid or not yet paid, because all the sins was taken on the death of Jesus Christ on the cross. So there's no more condemnation on Christ, in Christ now for us. No condemnation can be defined in a courtroom language. To have no condemnation declared means to be found innocent of the accusation, to have no sentence inflicted and no guilty verdict found. By the grace of God, believers in Jesus Christ will not face the condemnation of God. We have passed out of death into life. The Bible teaches that every human being will be brought before the judgment throne of God for an ultimate and decisive judgment. Sa 2 Corinthians po yan, chapter 5, verse 10. And Christ Himself will be the judge. We are all naturally under the condemnation of God. Whoever does not believe is condemned already. But Christians will not be found guilty on judgment day. However, the no condemnation involves more than the acquittal on judgment day. In Romans chapter 8 verse 10, the Apostle Paul speaks in the present tense as evidenced by the word now. Also notice the word therefore, which points the reader to the previous passage of Romans chapter 7 verse 21 to 25. In Romans 7, Paul describes his struggle against the sinful nature, a struggle that every believer experiences. Paul writes, "So I find it to be a law that when I want to do right, evil close at hand." Romans 7:21, and wretch man that I am. In Romans 7:24, Paul is expressing his hatred for the sinful nature, which continues to war against his new nature in Christ. Paul hates the sin he commit, but he is also thankful because he has been set free from slavery to sin. He now has the ability to do what is good because Christ has delivered him. Paul takes this step further in Romans 8 when he teaches believers are not only free from the bondage to sin. They are free from the inner emotion and thoughts that tend to bring feelings of condemnation to the Christian when he does commit sins. Romans 8 chapter verse 2, Christians are free from the law of sin and death, which means although they will commit sin, the law no longer has the power to condemn them. We are not under the law condemnation because Jesus fulfilled, filled up, completed the expectation of the law perfectly, and believers in Christ, because believers are in Christ, they have the joy of being counted as righteous simply because Christ is righteous. Paul also points out that genuine Christian, although they struggle, will not live according to the flesh. That is, they will not persist in constant state of sinful living. Sa Romans 8, chapter 8, verse 5 po. So, Paul encourages us that we need not fear condemnation because we can come to God as our loving God, forgiving Father. Sa Romans 8, chapter 15, verse 6, 15 to chapter 8, verses 15 to 16. Christians who live in shame and guilt over past failure are needlessly condemning themselves when they ought to be forgetting what lies behind and straining forward to what lies ahead. Fear can be paralyzing, but perfect love casts out fear. 1 John 4:18. As Christians, we must understand that our justification is found in Christ alone, in His finished work on the cross, not in what we do or don't do. Sa Romans chapter 3, verse 20. Believers can find solace in the assurance that we have been adopted into God's own family and have been made heirs of God and co-heirs with Christ. Romans 8, 17. Nothing can separate us from the love of Christ in Christ Jesus our Lord. So yan po, mga nakikinig po sa atin today. I have decided to follow the repentance message yesterday with the no condemnation message for today para maging balanse po ang lahat and we could have that assurance that there is no condemnation on us in Christ Jesus when we receive Him as our personal Savior and Lord. The condemnation of sin was done and committed and received by the death of Christ, no po, on the cross of Calvary for all our sin, past, present, and in the future. And if we really have acknowledged what Christ have done on us on the cross and receive Him as our personal Savior and Lord and receive the hope of eternal life, the gift, free gift of eternal life, we are already washed away. Our old sins, past, present, and future, was been washed away and was been, the payment was met already by Jesus on the cross of Calvary. That's why He died on the cross for all our sins. So the condemnation was received by God, Jesus Christ, and we are now living not under the sinful nature of our minds, but we are now under and living under the Spirit of God in us. Maraming salamat po, and I hope that this message will lighten up our self, that we should not be bothered anymore, and we should not be feeling guilty of whatever it is that we are doing. Of course, we are battling against sin of the world, and with the power of the Holy Spirit, we can rest assured that we could win over what is right in our lives. Once again, to our happy weekend po sa ating lahat. Have a blessed Friday. Friday today, and God bless po sa ating lahat. Thank you.